So based on the success of the phase two study, and I'm going to go over some of those results that triggered the phase three studies. So in the phase two study, we examined two different dosing schedules, weekly followed by daily, or daily followed by weekly, or daily all from the get-go and continued on daily schedules. And we identified that patients on all daily schedule and patients who received the 5 mg dose have had the most response and also had nearly no high-grade toxicities. So this was proving to be safe and actually the most effective dosing schedule. Our primary endpoints on the phase two study was objective splenic response, which we've achieved. At least one-third of patients have had achieved at least another 25% reduction in their splenic volume on top of their already response to ruxolitinib. So based on that, we have designed two prospective clinical trials. The first one, as you mentioned, is the randomized phase three study for patients already on ruxolitinib with a stable and optimized dose for at least 3 months, who continue to have suboptimal response as defined by universally accepted definition. And for those patients, we would add Parsaclisib at the dose of 5 mg daily continuously, and then versus placebo. And then patients would be evaluated for the primary endpoint with allowing crossover for patients or suboptimum responders or not having clinical benefit. So we're looking forward for that study. It is already accruing patients globally, and we look forward for having more options for our patients. The other phase three clinical trial, which we are very excited about, is to challenge and redefine what is the first-line therapy in patients with myelofibrosis. So for as the standard of care now is single-agent JAK inhibitors, we are randomizing patients between a standard on-label dose of ruxolitinib versus the same dose of ruxolitinib with the study drug. Of course, it's placebo-controlled. So we're comparing those two cohorts with also options of crossover eventually to see if we can improve first-line therapy for patients with myelofibrosis, especially that Parsaclisib has been associated with very mild adverse events and no treatment-related anemia, and only mild treatment-related thrombocytopenia, which makes it a very good partner for ruxolitinib. So hopefully that study will help redefine what is the standard of care first-line therapy for all patients with myelofibrosis, primary and secondary myelofibrosis.